Good morning, everyone. So welcome to the Yealink and Microsoft Global Roadshow. And it is our great honor and privilege to greet you all today in our third stop, North America. As you guys may know, my name is Tyler, and I'm the general manager here with Yealink. Please allow me to introduce our presenter today at Microsoft. I would like to introduce Liam, partner technology strategist at Microsoft, who is co-hosting this roadshow with me today. Liam, would you like to introduce yourself a little bit?
Excellent. Thanks. Great to be here, Tyler. My role at Microsoft is primarily around partner enablement, strategizing and making sure that all of our partners have everything that they need from the technical side of things for successful Teams Rooms deployments. And I'm going to be joined today with Tyler. So we'll review some of these options that we have to look into from the device perspective.
Right. Thank you, Liam. I'm sure that today we're going to proactively interact with all attendees and they would have a lot of questions for us. And so thank you for your time here today with us. I'd like to properly introduce Yealink to all of our partners. Yealink has been a global unified communication and collaboration solution provider since 2001. We have covered vibrant and various product lines, including desk IP phone, video conferencing solutions, and personal peripherals. Within the past 20 years, we have grown rapidly and have gone public with a market share with more than $10 billion. A few achievements and competitive edge that I'd like to highlight to you. We have now become a global number one SIP phone provider since 2018, with the capability to serve customers from more than 140 countries through global and local distributors. Speaking about our relationship with Microsoft specifically, as claimed earlier, we have been partnered together since the Microsoft Link era in 2015, and now we have become a Microsoft top communication partner with three outstanding achievements. We are now the fastest growing vendor of Microsoft Teams Room measured by year-on-year figures, and have now also become the first and only provider that is capable of delivering a full range Microsoft Teams certified solutions among the Teams Phone, Teams Room, and personal devices. Combining our previous strengths on IP phones specifically and the Teams platform and services, we are also now the number one team phone provider in the globe. Today's main topic, equitable hybrid workplace meeting experience. Before we share what solutions we have had, I'd like to pass it on to Liam to share his thoughts about current challenges and insights in hybrid workplace from a Microsoft perspective. Over to you, Liam.
Thanks, Tyler. Yeah, so as you mentioned, you know, we saw some dates back there all the way back from 2015, back in the old Link days. And there were certainly challenges, you know, during that time. The challenges have grown and evolved as the needs have for the masses. And really the pandemic kind of threw everyone for a loop. So there are, you know, inherent challenges that come along with trying to structure and figure out what is the best way for us to handle meetings as we move forward. And to really do that, we thought about trying to analyze, okay, what are the foundational changes that have occurred in how we used to work versus today? And what that really means is that there are new requirements that are put in place that help us to be able to work better and more efficient, even in kind of the disjointed and slightly disconnected mentality of the world today. We're looking at trying to bring everyone back together. And like I mentioned, there's some challenge certainly that come with that situation. What we really need to do is we need to break away from the old habits and start looking towards new, better ways to do our work together. And that new normal, I mean, even though the phrase is pretty popular, get back to the new normal, what that really means is that new normal, it needs to be flexible and dynamic and not really static like the way it used to be. And there's a lot of vision that's involved with trying to come up with better ways to do these kinds of, you know, work-based tasks that we've had traditionally, comparatively how we used to do them. Okay. From a business perspective, are the customers actually ready for this new hybrid workplace? Because for the most part, we're seeing that change has not really started to implement until very, very recently. And some people start to feel a little bit of a panic situation kicking in. So what we want to do is really kind of take the reins on there and guide our partners and our customers into being able to ease into this new hybrid workplace type of dynamic. We took a look also at through surveys. We have what's called a work trend index internally here, and we did a finding study that it interacted with over 30,000 people in 31 countries. So pretty broad type of surveying that we did to try to figure out how is this being impacted. And what we've looked at is about 73% of the workers that are in the workforce today say that they actually want more, you know, flexible type of work environments. They want that to stay in place. They've had a taste of it now of being able to work from home, and they've recognized that they're doing their work better and more efficiently, and they would like to carry on with that type of mentality moving forward. And from the organizational standpoint, we've looked at the management side of things too. And really, there's about 80% of those managers that say that they want to be able to anticipate and they expect more flexible working from home or working remotely types of policies that are going to be put in place after the pandemic subsides. So we're seeing that customers and workers want it, and also IT staff wants it too. So we need to be prepared for it. There's a bit of a catch with the ability to work remotely though too. It's just kind of an inherent thing that some of the people feel like they're less connected with each other than they used to be. You know, they don't have that camaraderie that they had of being able to walk into the office, hang out with their coworkers, really experience, you know, things together. And they're doing these things in a remote type of fashion now. So this is where video and audio together with it really comes into play to keep them feeling like they're actually connected. And we also looked at the fact that about at the same time that all these numbers were being factored in, there's about 67% of employees that say that they want in-person collaboration. So this is, again, where that hybrid scenario kicks in, that you've got people on both sides of the fence that want to continue to do things remotely, and then they also want to be able to do things in person. So we look at how to plan ahead for those situations with devices and, you know, application capabilities that span a remote situation and also an on-site in the office type of situation. But keeping that in mind, there's also recognizing how systems and rooms themselves have been deployed today. And really, there's about 93% of those rooms that are deployed globally that they're equipped with like minimal technologies to actually have an adequate room system associated to them. So there's a lot of growth capabilities into making those older rooms brought up to speed in the modern era with the modern workplace and a hybrid aspect of things, you know, in place. There's a usability factor too, where a large percentage, you know, more than half, 63% of people say that they would actually use video conferencing rooms more if they were equipped with better devices. You know, and it's not just cameras, it's also speakers. We've all been on those meetings where someone joins from a laptop in a meeting room and they've got their mic, you know, still left on, and you start hearing that audio feedback back and forth between the devices. That's not a good situation. People don't want that. So in partnerships with Yealink, we've looked at how to better the device experience so that you don't have those situations, make them more favorable. And that situation is going to increase, not one or even double or triple. The projections on it have it forecasted at a 6-time difference in how the devices were deployed before and seeding them out to expanding more devices in more rooms by a factor of 6. So that's supposed to be coming out by 2025. So right on the horizon here, a massive, massive growth potential. We talk about changes that of the way things used to be, people feeling disconnected, like they weren't actually really a part of the meeting. They were just kind of like watching in the background. We want to foster the inclusivity aspect of things, no matter where those people are. And we want it to be easy to use. We want devices that are simplified and not complicated and be able to be set up and configured either in advance or even during ad hoc meeting situations. And we want those devices also to be flexible in the room systems that they're available for. And part of that is really identifying, you know, what type of device is most applicable for the type of room that's actually going to be used. So we're going to talk about that part here in just a moment. And I think one of the key things, more than likely from the IT perspective side of the house, is that they want to make sure that they have devices that are very secured and able to be managed up to their corporate specifications that they have. So partnering with Yealink, we have purpose-built devices that are configured with the Microsoft Teams version of it that's applicable applicable to a meeting room type of environment. And behind the scenes on there, it's not just about the device itself, it's about the analytics that come with it, really being able to validate, you know, what is the ROI of the device and the room system that we've chosen to invest in today.
Yealink and Microsoft have developed to address all these needs and demands. So here I'd like to share with you that Yealink has actually had three strategic product lines, Microsoft certified product lines, including video conferencing kits on Windows and Android, personal devices such as Teams room panels, AI speaker, webcam, headset, and speakers, anything like that. And last but not least, the Teams phones. I'd like to specifically highlight our room systems. Right? We deliver solutions for both Android and Windows-based solutions. Our Microsoft Teams room system on Windows is what we call the MVC series, produces the best meeting quality and extremely popular when it comes to medium to large spaces, given its flexibility on and customization factors. On the other hand, our Android all-in-one collaboration bar simplifies and ease the process of the deployment, providing an easy to use and integrated solution that is perfect for huddle to medium room spaces. Before we dig into, you know, the features and advantage of product portfolio and specifically advantages of Yealink Microsoft certified video conferencing solutions. Here, I'd like to specifically highlight our Teams room solutions on Windows. So long story short, there are four phrases I'd like to conclude as unique selling points, which are easy to deploy, flexible and audio options, exclusive for extra large meeting room, and obviously AI feature room systems. So here at Yealink as a vendor of Microsoft, our ultimate goal is to deliver an immersive meeting experience to our clients. So in the past, let's say face-to-face interactions is probably the easiest way or the most efficient way when it comes to in a form of a meeting. But with the pandemic situation going on, accelerating this hybrid work style, remote meeting are more and more encouraged and adopted. But how do we keep things simple and easy to understand when it comes to deploy and use the technology? I think the answer starts from simplify the procedure in order to democratize our product offerings. So our first advantage is that we simplify the process of deployment with the OneCAT5e technology. Specifically, there's only one cable needed between the table area and the TV. Users with little or no or limited IT background will still know how to use it. As if you are just using a smartphone, right? Plug and play and easy to use. So that, on the other hand, also provides a super tidy and clean table, which I think everyone loves that style. And our second advantage, I guess, is the flexibility on audio options. Specifically for medium to large meeting spaces, we provide options such as wireless DAC mic, Wi-Fi mic, ceiling mic, and table mics, and more. And here I'd like to provide an example as our MVC 940. So this is a perfect example in the sense of using a VCM 3038 ceiling mic other than a table mic or wireless microphone, considering, as you can see in the pictures here, with the room sizes like that, tables and around, I guess ceiling mic is absolutely the one to go when it comes to room sizes like that to ensure voice pickup and stuff like that. And also with MVC 940, it can also support up to nine cameras. Just stands out as the only solution provider to offer standardized multi-cam solutions in an extra large room scenario. Then I also like to highlight our newly launched devices as a result of development with Microsoft Teams. We have introduced our Yealink and Speech as the first AI speaker capable of using, you know, features such as voice command like, hey Cortana, or, you know, Microsoft transcription without any physical touch. Liam just talked about, you know, social distancing. I think this is just going to be very helpful and handy given the pandemic situation where, you know, social distancing nowadays is so encouraged. We have also just launched our newly, you know, Teams room panel that again shapes the whole Teams rooms ecosystem with the LED bar on the sides that could easily detect the room status. That's just easy to use at the end of the day. So after a brief introduction on our Android collaboration bar A20 and A30 and how we designed that to address today's, you know, requirements. Again, it becomes so simple and even way simpler to set up a collaboration bar than a Windows-based solutions. With only three steps, you could set up the bar just as if you are, you know, unbox or set up your smartphone. We also think that bringing in an immersive meeting experience can't be possible without intelligence. With features such as auto framing and speaker tracking, it helps prevent audiences, you know, kind of represent your eyes to capture the whole scene automatically. just as if you are in a face-to-face meeting with someone, no remote control is needed. You just have to sit there, be there on your seat, and then wait for the technology to solve the problem just by itself. We are also proud to be the only vendor capable of carrying wireless sharing options for Teams Room Android solutions. So things like with the WPP20 presentation dongle, you can share and sync your content to the TV within seconds. Last but not least, our A20 or A30 collaboration bar is supplied by a powerful processor. With a Snapdragon A45 processor, it allows the devices to upgrade up to Android 11 and upgrade to the latest Teams Room features released by Microsoft and Yealink specifically. Unlike the previous Snapdragon A35, just can't do these kind of features. So here is just kind of like a scene we imagine and define. A lot of our customers, they also have a lot of requests on our Teams Room panel and how they integrate with our bundle solutions. So why don't we just talk about Teams Room panel then? So here, I think my questions for you though is, what's positioning for Teams Room panel from a Microsoft perspective?
We feel at Microsoft that the Teams Room panel, it just makes sense to complement a room system itself. We've all been in that situation where we're like walking down a hallway, we're trying to find a meeting room, we can't tell which room is available, which room's already booked. And wouldn't it be great if there was just some kind of signage outside the room that we could see this at a glance? And that's really where the panel systems come into play today. We have a digital display that shows not just that the meeting is occurring maybe in a room, but also the meetings that are scheduled for that room, so that, like I said, give the example, someone's walking through trying to find somewhere where they can actually take a meeting from, they can see that that room is actually going to continue to be booked maybe throughout the course of the day, and they need to find somewhere else. Okay, now what do you do? The Teams panel itself will also allow that person walking by to be able to input onto that panel and try to find another location. And what will happen behind the scenes is that the panel will know the layout based on the Teams administration and configuration aspect of things and make a suggestion that, hey, we see that there's another room available that you can take your meeting in, and here's the directions on how to get there. And it can even do things like pull up a floor plan to actually map out so the person knows where they're going in the office. In addition to that, those devices, you know, it's not just limited to the meeting experience. So you talk about a lot of flexibility there. There are applications that can be leveraged on the panel systems to be able to use things like, you walk into a meeting and you're missing like the markers, for example. You need markers for the whiteboard. You can actually use that panel to make requests for any kind of facilities needs that may occur. Or, this meeting's running long. We want to use that panel right there to order, you know, catering or something like that for the people who are stuck in the meeting for longer. And then we've seen another really interesting type of situation where maybe the administrator of the meeting itself wants to, they realize that the meetings run long and people were going to miss the rides that they were going to take before. They can actually leverage applications that are built for these kinds of devices to do things like order taxis or rideshare services to pick people up when the meeting actually is over. So there's a ton of flexibility with these panels, and I'm really proud that Yealink has come to market with these.
Really appreciate that comment, sir, because your explanation just been so meaningful, because people just think that this room panel is just a scheduling panel, but actually can do more than just scheduling and things like that. And Liam, so I would like to actually go back to, you know, things like collaboration bar, A20, A30, because we just talked about that previously. Mm-hmm. And here's my questions, also a question from our Yealink customer, that is, why customers would think that Teams Room system would be a perfect option for small to medium size spaces? And what's Microsoft's competitive advantages, especially in this SMB market specifically, given that previously we shared that 68% of market opportunities are around these areas?
It's really about flexibility at the end of the day, being able to leverage devices that are able to be used for any type of room system. And this is where like the Android bars really come into play. So for those small to medium-sized rooms, you can't get much more simplified than one of those all-in-one units to be able to deploy very quickly and easily. And the funny thing is that a lot of people think, why would Microsoft, you know, push Android? Why wouldn't it just be pure Windows-based devices? And like I mentioned in the beginning, we recognize that the way we used to do things, has changed and it needs to continue to change, and flexibility is really at the core component of that. So at the end of the day, you know, what's the best room system out there to use? It's the one that you enjoy using. So it doesn't matter whether it's Android based, if you have a preference in that route, absolutely. We have devices with our partners in Yealink to be able to provide for that. Or if it's a pure Windows based solutions, you have the Teams room systems like the MVC series that can certainly handle those kinds of deployments.
Exactly. Liam, you know, while we're just talking about Teams room panel, like you said before.
Since Liam and Taylor for sharing. Hello, everyone. My name is Dawson, Product Manager from Yealink. Now, I would like to introduce our vision of virtual meetings. Because of the COVID virus, the way people work in have been changed and continue to change. Some people work from home, and some people work in office. Or people sometimes work from home and sometimes go to office will become the new normal. In this new situation, the hybrid working would lead to a new transformation to the collaborative communication device, including the device in meeting room and also the device on desktop. Recently, we do see some new requirements from the market. People are no longer satisfied with the meetings which they can see and hear. For some meetings, such as brainstorming, project planning, or problem solving, they want, they can do collaboration just like all the people in one space. Based on this new requirement, today I bring you two Yealink brand new Teams collaboration device. One is Yealink Meeting Board 65 for rooms, and the other is Yealink AIO 24 for desk. Both these two products are all in one design, integrated with the computing unit, premium camera, microphone, speaker, and also a touch screen for whiteboarding features.
The Yealink Meeting Board 65 mostly will be used in meeting room from small to large. It also can be used in the manager's independent office and, of course, the classrooms of education. There are three core advantages of this product. First, it is an all-in-one product, almost integrate everything in the room. It equips with a 4K 65 inches touch display, the 4K camera, beamforming microphone array and speaker array. It is used a high performance 8-core chipset with the Android 10 OS. So one Yealink Meeting Board is equal to a video room system plus a TV, plus a physical whiteboard, but it is much easier for installation, central and remote device management. Second is premier intelligent camera and audio quality. The Yealink Meeting Board built in a 4K and 120 degree wide view camera to cover small rooms. Firmware optional, a 4K PDC camera module, which can simply integrate into the board to build an intelligent dual camera system, together with the Yealink wireless extension microphones to cover the medium and large rooms, and can support up to 4K 60 frames hardware encoding decoding capability to ensure a premium video quality. In the audio part, it used an independent and air-capable audio processor equipped with 16 beamforming microphones and total 30 watts array speakers to ensure up to 8 meters for duplex premium audio quality. For the AI features, it supports Yealink new generation AI-driven noise cancellation technology, as well as auto framing and speaker tracking. Depends on its powerful hardware, it can support more and more Teams intelligent camera features in future. Third, native Microsoft whiteboarding experience. All by the Microsoft whiteboarding service, Yealink Meeting Board turns the traditional physical whiteboard into a digital one. Breaking out the limitation of distance and space, users can enjoy jumping into an ideation meeting. The premium inking diagrams for its components near rich content will help to boost creativity and productivity compared with the cluttered paper materials or simple meeting recap. Yealink Meeting Board will be integrated with Microsoft Teams seamlessly, offers a better collaborative experience like content sharing in Teams, openly existing whiteboard from SharePoint, and so on. Yealink Meeting Board is the platform where people and information come together digitally for better collaboration and productivity. Our next new product is Yealink AIO24 Teams Display Device. It integrates the camera, speakerphone, and the PC extended touchable monitor, offer a more dedicated collaboration device for people to focus on their work. The primary scenario that comes to our mind is the putting it in a dedicated desk. The target audience could be managers or home workers who has dedicated space for working, or those who are highly reliant on Teams collaboration features like meetings or whiteboarding. It also can be placed in shared space for hot desking, as well as for some phone rooms with 2 to 3 people. There are 4 aspects that we believe the AIO product could tell a good story in the market. First, this is a dual-mode product. Of course, it is a native Teams display device. And by using a low latency and high refresh rate display, it also can be a monitor for your daily use. Second, premium audio and video experience. Third, UC workstation with USB hub and charging to your laptop, as well as QI wireless charging to your smartphone. Fourth, enriched Teams display features such as instant messaging, calendar, whiteboarding, Cortana. The above is my sharing today for these 2 Yealink brand new Teams collaboration device. For more information, please connect to our live demo. Thank you.